Hi everyone. As
Hello.
promised, we go live on Facebook to address your queries regarding the UPSC examination. जैसे कि सबको लगता है कि UPSC examination काफी tough होती है and rightly so. People from different fields sit for it. बहुत सारे लोग बैठते हैं and at different levels of their education. So that makes it very very tough. But as Athar and I both can vouch for, if you have a smart strategy, अगर आपकी एक smart strategy हो तो it's very very easy actually to tackle the examination. So जो मेरा पहले एक post था उस पर काफ़ी सारे questions आप लोगों ने डाले थे and उसमें से मुझे एक general idea मिल गया कि what are the main problems that aspirants are facing. So we'll try to focus on those today. And we'll again try to do this sometime later. मान लो कुछ छूट गया हो या कुछ चीज़ हम address ना कर पाए हों. So I think to first question हम सबको यहाँ address करना चाहिए कि ये exam किस चीज़ को लेकर है, क्या exactly हमें हमारा main focus रहना चाहिए इस examination में, so that we have a clear idea what are we dealing with. So UPSC examination per se, I think it's more about what's happening around you. आपके आसपास क्या चल रहा है, देश में क्या चल रहा है, विदेश में क्या चल रहा है. सो यू नीड टू बी वेरी अवेयर एंड वेरी कॉन्शियस ऑफ एनीथिंग एंड एवरीथिंग अराउंड यू. अथवा यू वुड वांट टू से समथिंग ऑन दिस?
या शी इज एब्सोल्युटली राइट. यू नो आई थिंक यू नो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू गेट एन ओवरव्यू ऑफ व्हाट दिस एग्जामिनेशन इज ऑल अबाउट, व्हाट इज द डिमांड ऑफ दिस एग्जामिनेशन, एंड वंस अंडरस्टैंडिंग देन यू शुड प्लान योर प्रिपरेशन अकॉर्डिंगली. So she's absolutely right that this examination is all about, you know, understanding the things around you, understanding your country well, understanding, you know, what's going on in the world. So like
I said, understanding what's happening. So it's very simple. To understand what's happening in present, you need to know what has happened in the past. So history becomes important. To understand what's around you, you need to know your geography well. To understand how your economy is performing, of course, you need to get your economics right. So that's how, you know, the whole UPSC exam is all about. So of course, a clear bias hai towards humanities. We are mostly dealing with subjects which are towards the liberal arts. So of course, jahan utna science and technology use nahi hota hai, jo probably say other competitive exams mein use hota hai. So here you need to be very good in say history, very good in your polity and law, very good in geography, very good in philosophy. So you have to first get this fact straight that this is a humanities oriented exam. And jab aapko ye acche se samajh aa jayega to apni strategy bhi waise hi orient karenge. Now agar hum strategy ki baat kare to as per your questions मेरे को डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स ने अप्रोच किया. स्टूडेंट्स हु आर इन स्कूल, स्टूडेंट्स हु आर इन कॉलेज, स्टूडेंट्स हु आर डन विद कॉलेज एंड वॉन्ट टू नाउ प्रिपेयर फॉर द एग्जाम, एंड दोज एस्पिरेंट्स हु आर ऑल्सो वर्किंग प्रोफेशनल्स जो पार्ट टाइम जॉब कर रहे हैं. सो वी आर डीलिंग विद डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स, एंड जैसे सबके सर्कमस्टेंसेज अलग हैं, सबके लेवल ऑफ एजुकेशन अलग है, तो सबकी ऑफकोर्स स्ट्रैटेजी भी डिफरेंट होगी. सो आई थिंक विल गो स्टेप बाय स्टेप. Since I also started preparing from school, so probably I can take on that. When we are in school, of course, I think the main focus should be clearing your boards, board examination. So don't take too much pressure into thinking कि अभी से ही हम UPSC का इतना पढ़ लेंगे. It's not possible. आपकी अपनी उतनी age भी नहीं हुई है, ना ही उतनी education level हुई है. But of course, it's very good to start early. So the only thing you can do is develop newspaper reading. And focus on the 11th and 12th NCERTs because those books only become the core books for preparation for UPSC. So apna aap kaam halka kar sakte ho by focusing on your school studies very well. And of course, if you can develop newspaper reading habit, then nothing like it. If I think we need to take a break here for one moment. There's a phone ringing. Yeah. Really sorry.
Okay, no,
I think. कौन था? इफ यू आर इन कॉलेज देन आई थिंक द स्ट्रैटेजी शुड बी कि आप वो ही ग्रेजुएशन सब्जेक्ट चुने विच यू थिंक यू विल ऑल्सो परस्यू फॉर योर मेन्स. For instance, I had decided way before that I would choose political science as my optional in the mains examination. Thereby, I took political science also as my graduation subject. So obviously, उसने मेरी help करी examination में. Even अगर आप वो subject नहीं चुन पाए जो probably आप optional की तरह चुन रहे हैं, so probably try to orient your own subject towards that. Probably say if you're doing geography honors, so think about geography as your optional for the examination and start preparing for that. Acha. Again, if you're in college, I think newspaper reading again helps. And college is the right time to actually start serious preparation towards newspaper reading. Like I said, the UPSC examination is all about what happens around you. And the best way to keep track of that is do a lot of newspaper reading. So, every day you have to spend nearly two hours on newspaper. So, you would like to chip in here for college
yes,
students?
Actually, we have also got a lot of questions out here. We're just going through some of them. First thing, as she was telling you well elaborately, you know, how to go about it. And I think one thing that you need to be very, you know, sincere about is a proper study plan. So if you are in college or if you are working somewhere, it becomes even more important to you because, you know, time is absolutely not a luxury for you. It's a scarce resource for you. So make a proper plan that, you know, like every day if you are, you know, taking out at least 4-5 hours, whatever you are able to, you know, make best use of that time. So that is, I think, one very, very important mantra for clearing the examination. I think we are having a lot of questions here. We can go through these questions. I'll just read out some of the questions.
And also, we need to address people who are already doing the job and preparing for the exam. Because that's one question I often get. I think people who are also working, since I was not working, so I'm probably not the right person to address this. But I think even if you're working in a, like a lot of my colleagues were working while preparing for the examination, you still need to somehow take out 5 to 6 hours to study. If not six, at least 4 to 5 hours. And probably, you know, like I know people who have got selected and who were already doing a job. So, you know, they had very clever tactics how to, you know, spend their time studying as well as working. For instance, one very good friend of mine, he was already in a job and every morning to commute to his workplace used to take around 2 hours. So he used to listen to news during that point of time and even download news videos or debate videos. And that's how he kept track of current affairs. So you need to formulate your own strategy, how to take out those 4 to 5 hours for study every day. We can go through the questions which are coming in.
Okay, so I'll start with the top.
The last one.
So, I'm in second year of graduation. Is it necessary to join coaching? So you can speak about
well,
that.
Well, yes, a lot of questions coming regarding to the importance of coaching. See, if you get a teacher, it's always good, right? Like you'll get more help. But a lot of people can do even without it. So this question is actually a very personal question in the sense that it depends from person to person. So if you think you'll study only when you have a teacher on your head, then fine, go for coaching. If you think you can do, you are self-disciplined and you can do your own self-study, then of course coaching is not required. Also, there are questions regarding whether only coaching gets you selected. No. In fact, a majority of those who don't take coaching get selected. So coaching is not the only thing which will get you selected. Regarding a lot of people have issues about affordability of coaching. Well, nearly the study material and even the videos of teachers of nearly all coaching institutes are available online. So affordability again is not a question. All you need is a good internet connection. So I think that's
something. Yeah, that's indeed true. Another important aspect is once you are joined coaching, make sure that you take best use of it. Many times what happens is that, you know, you go to some coaching classes, they're teaching you something during the class, and once you come back you don't even bother to go through what you have been taught in the class. So I think it's
like
important.
When I was in Delhi, and the same thing, like a lot of students in my coaching institute would be busy on their phones, would not be interested in class. So that's just waste of time and money. So don't do that. If you've joined a coaching institute, please take full advantage of this.
Okay, so I think it's important that, you know, after classes, go back, revise that those notes well, what you have been taught in the classes. And after, you can also go through other books, you know, from which you can further supplement what you have been taught in the class. That would be important. And apart from that, you know, it's again not an absolute necessary to join coaching. There are, in fact, within our batch, there are majority of, if not majority, at least a substantial number of those, you know, selected candidates are ones who have not joined any kind of coaching. Yet, at times, you know, if you join a test series or something, that does happen, that does help. More important, be pretty liberal in taking notes, you know, don't have this mentality that you don't want to, you know, even, if, you know,
yeah.
Fetch notes from somewhere.
I think there's a lot of student ego in this, that, you know, no, I've understood it, so mujhe to yaad rahega. Kuch yaad rehta nahi hai, aap ek do din baad wo bhool jayenge. It's human nature. So, don't be adamant ki main ye note nahi karunga ya nahi karungi. Be very generous in your notings. In fact, आप कभी न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ें, कोई किताब पढ़ रहे हो, कुछ भी पढ़ रहे हो, अगर आपको कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट लगता है कि अच्छा ये शायद मेरे एग्जामिनेशन से कुछ रिलेटेड है, ऑलवेज टेक अ नोटिंग.
ओके, देयर इज वन वेरी कॉमन क्वेश्चन, दे से प्लीज गिव अ लिस्ट ऑफ सम बुक्स व्हिच